So this week, people are talking about the newest trend in real estate called the re-urbanization movement. Since the 1920s, the suburban population growth rate has consistently outpaced big cities. Residents were attracted to the idea of safer, quieter communities, getting more real estate for their money, and access to better school systems for their children. Since 2011, however, the annual growth rate of cities has definitely surpassed the suburbs, according to the U.S. Census Bureau data. This re-urbanization into the cities is also known as the live, work, play communities. You're probably hearing a lot about it, where you can step out your front door and go to restaurants, shopping markets, even walk to work in a small community. Heck, it was great when we lived in San Francisco at 101 California, and we could just go downstairs, and on the left side it was Chinese, and on the right side it was German. You can see signs of this type of modern development in most of our local areas, and guess who's the most attracted to this lifestyle? Yep. The millennials. Several factors are at play here, including the recent recession and housing crisis. With the steep declines in housing values 5+ years ago, homeowners that are getting back into the market are seeking property with more stability and values. The high fuel costs are also a factor, while high gasoline costs have workers looking to live closer to their jobs and retail centers. As for the demographic trends, in addition to the millennials, some baby boomer retirees are actually downsizing and moving to cities to be closer to retail, culture amenities as well, just being able to go to the show. What a great thing. So as more buyers start navigating the re-urbanization movement, keeping up on the real estate market in downtown, midtown, or local cities can be really critical to finding that perfect home for your next client. So here's a look at some of the new listings in our area this week. A lot of great movement. And now for minding your own business. So this week we're going to be talking about video marketing your listings to millennials. Now I know we've talked a lot about video marketing, but we are in an ever-changing world and video is definitely no exception. According to the article by Nick Gady on Inman, which is a very powerful news source, 98% of 18 to 34 year olds watch video content on their smartphone on a daily basis. You probably know this because you probably do it yourself. So here are 5 quick tips for renovating your real estate videos for the millennial audience. Number 1, keep it short. Videos eat data and data costs money, so keep it short. Remember that video is merely one of the many components in your comprehensive real estate package. Number 2, don't get cute. Remember, you're a real estate agent, not a comedian, so just get to the point. Show the viewer what they came to look for, a quick video of a house that they might want. Number 3, don't overbrand. If your video is taking up too much time on your introduction and filled with graphics on how to connect with you, so you're creating noise and people don't want to hear that. They're getting distracted and they don't know what's important. So you want to get the viewer's attention right away before they bounce, or else you're going to lose them. Again, the primary goal here is to get the viewer to like the listing and then contact you. So they won't care what company you work for until you've established credibility and that they're interested in your video. Number 4, choose a good song. People like music and it ties it to you, so choose a unique, high quality song with real instruments, one that viewers feel good listening to, and one that doesn't make too much noise and keep your viewers engaged in the video. You can check out some of the great options at musicbed.com or for a cheaper alternative, premiumbeat.com. Number 5, be honest with yourself. Take out your smartphone, pull up one of your listing videos and watch through the whole thing through the eye of the viewer. Do you get bored? Do you get distracted? Put the video on mute so that you're not listening to yourself. Your impressions will mirror your audience's. Then you can go about fixing any problems that you have. If you're unable to connect with the audience, you put yourself at risk of aging out on your job. So take a long look at your videos and get started on those renovations before the market matures and you miss out. Well, Well, thanks again for watching this edition of the Real Estate Insider Weekly. Keep your comments coming. They're very important to us. We really want to hear from you. If we can be of assistance in providing mortgage products to your clients, be sure to contact us. We'd love to advise them and help you close your deals. Have a great week.